you're going to need your rotor assembly, a hammer, a small flathead screwdriver, a brass or other non-magnetic screwdriver, a pick for dealing with O-rings, a putty knife, and a die grinder or similar rotary tool with a cutoff wheel attachment. You'll begin by using the small magnetic screwdriver to locate two magnets. Once you've located two magnets, use a marker to draw a straight line between them. Rotate the rotor assembly 180 degrees and repeat this process. You now have guidelines on both sides for cutting away and removing the sleeve. Using the die grinder with cutoff wheel attachment, begin on one side and cut along the sleeve using the guidelines you just drew. Working slow and steady is the key to removing the sleeve successfully and without damage. During cutting, you want to make sure you avoid the magnets beneath the sleeve and avoid damaging the inner ring that holds the magnets in place. The cutoff wheel should just cut through the sleeve while minimizing contact with the inner ring. You may need to run your cut along the bottom of the sleeve as well. Once you've made cuts on both sides, you can begin to pry the sleeve away using the brass screwdriver. It's important to use the brass screwdriver or other non-magnetic prying tool here, as the magnets will make using other tools more difficult. We'll now speed up the process. Once the sleeve has been successfully cut and pried loose, remove it from the assembly and set it aside. Now will be a good time to inspect the remaining components for damage. At this point, we are ready to remove the magnets from the inner ring. Using the putty knife and brass screwdriver, and working from the end closest to the rotor, begin to pry and move the magnets out of the inner ring by sliding them toward the back. Remove them one at a time and set them aside. Once all the magnets have been removed from the inner ring, use the pick to remove the O-ring from the groove closest to the rotor. With the first O-ring removed, next, turn it on the rotor end and remove the O-ring from the groove at the back. Before installing new magnets, it is a good idea to clean the assembly with a rag. Inspect for damage to the radial and thrust bushings as well. If any bushings need replacement, you should do that now. You will now install the magnets. The inner ring is machined to make this installation easy. Each magnet segment will have a white line on one side and be blank on the other. The white line indicates polarity. When installing the magnets, they should be placed in alternating fashion, side by side, in the inner ring assembly. Continue this alternating pattern until all of the magnets have been placed. Thank you. Use the non-magnetic screwdriver to ensure each magnet segment is fully seated. The factory will check polarity of the assembly using an insulated magnet tool. Now it is time to install the O-rings. Begin with the O-ring at the rear of the rotor assembly. Start by placing the O-ring in its groove. Apply grease to help retain it during sleeve assembly. Once you have the rear O-ring installed, it is time to install the O-ring on the rotor end of the assembly. As before, apply a small amount of grease to help with retention during sleeve pressing. Next, we will install the sleeve onto the rotor assembly. This will require a hydraulic press. The inner ring is placed on a fixture to hold it in place during assembly. Place the sleeve as shown, making sure the depressions in the sleeve align with the magnets. Use the press to apply downward force and set the sleeve in place. This should be done in one fluid motion. If the sleeve doesn't fully assemble, increase the pressure of the press until it is seated. Remove the assembly from the press and make sure it was pressed completely. The back of the rotor assembly should be making contact with the rear of the sleeve, and the O-rings should be covered completely. The last step performed by the factory is rolling of the edges of the sleeve. The sleeve is rotated, and a tool is used to roll the edge nearest the rotor. While this isn't a necessary step, it is highly recommended, and all factory supplied rotors will have this feature. Shown now is a finished assembly. Thank you for watching. Be sure and hit the like button, and if you enjoyed this video, subscribe to stay up to date with the latest on all of Blackmer's technologies.
PSG, where innovation flows.